Oh, look at this. This is a shot that no one will ever see again. Unbelievable.
The winds have died down on Lake Manitoba, but the damage caused by Tuesday's storm is plain to see. Debris, wood, dead fish litter the shores of Twin Lakes Beach on the east shores of Lake Manitoba. At times, winds were gusting up to 100 kilometers per hour, so fast residents barely had time to get out of their homes before the floodwaters came. With lake waters crashing over land, it was a race to get out before the main road to Twin Lakes Beach was completely washed out.
So I grabbed a few papers that were important and I tried to get down the road and I was like, I don't even know how deep the water was, but it was really scary to drive through it.
Within a matter of hours, hundreds of homes and cottages along the east shore of Lake Manitoba were flooded and 90 permanent residents were forced to evacuate.
We had to go, myself, I went up with a helicopter and we went to a couple of locations where we actually pulled people out of their cottages.
Two people were airlifted to safety. No one was hurt, but the aftermath is painful.
All right. My heart goes out to you too, pal.
We tried to salvage as much as we could, but we lost everything. Like the home is flooded. It's like the movie The Titanic, but there's freezers, fridge, you know, all over the place. Everything is floating.
Not even sandbag dikes could hold back crashing waves, measured at times between 6 and 8 feet high.
People that came and volunteered to fill sandbag, they worked so hard, and you know, it's sad to see it was all for nothing because the water took everything away.
It's now up to emergency measures officials to determine when it'll be safe for people to return to what's left of their lakeside properties. But with water and debris still covering many roads, it may be days before evacuees return home. In Twin Lakes Beach, I'm Nicole Dubé.